It's now November the 5th. And I'm just doing a follow-up on my situation. I had to build this trailer because he was supposed to put a wheelchair lift on my vehicle and he never did. And my last video I did, I showed you how I had to leave this wheelchair out in the rain. I brought it back to him because the motors are ruined on it because it's making a whole bunch of noise. And now I come over here this morning on November the 5th, Saturday morning, and I see my wheelchair sitting outside covered in frost. Yeah. Battery's really low, I guess it's probably frozen. But I'm gonna move this chair and you'll get to hear how much noise it makes. It used to make absolutely no sound at all. It doesn't move. Oh well. Anyway, I bought this chair off of him. It was like practically brand new. I put different foot pedals on and my own seat covers. And altogether, this chair probably cost me almost $3,000. And I've never had the chair working. Oh, I also put new batteries in it. And he had it at his store on Dutch Village Road. And when I looked at it, every time I saw it, my chair was, the power was left turned on. And anyway, the brand new batteries are not, probably are not brand new, and they never worked. I would never had this chair in my possession for more than a week since I bought it. And I got ripped off pretty bad. And these kinds of things happen because we have no laws in this province of Nova Scotia, basically Halifax, to protect disabled people. And that's company up here. And he also now is known himself as Dragonebikes and Dragonebikes. So my wheelchair is ruined, and I'll never see my money back, and I never got to use it. I only bought this wheelchair as a spare because my other wheelchair, he took like 9-10 months to get it so I could use it. And the other wheelchair cost me like, I don't know, $45,000. And he screwed my life up really good because in January I made a deal with him that I would pay him so much money to get my custom chair made. So I would have it for June, have my car ready, everything ready so I can go to work. And it's now November, and I still haven't got this chair running. Actually, this is December the 4th today, I think. Anyway, this is what it's like being disabled. You're at the mercy of criminals. And the government is the one that's probably the biggest criminal because they're allowing this to happen. So go to wheelchairrights.wordpress.com to find out more about what it's like to get to be in Nova Scotia and being disabled. And yes, I can walk, stupid people that keep saying that. What do you know? You can see my broken spine and all my broken ribs. You have no idea how little I can walk and how I have to have a wheelchair to get around. My life is a nightmare. And the biggest nightmare is because I have to deal with really stupid, ignorant people that sit there and judge and criticize and leave stupid comments under my videos. Like the fact that the Halifax public transit buses don't have it. I'll show you right there. This is a tie down point right here. And there's another one back here. Yep, can you see it? Where is it? I'll show it to you. It's back there. And this is another tie down point. Why do you think they put tie down points on these heavy chairs? Because they have to be tied down on 4 points so they don't move around while the bus is traveling. And all the new buses and HRM don't have any tie down straps to hold down wheelchairs, so people in wheelchairs can no longer go anywhere. Life is a mess in this town. Bye.